Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 3, Episode 9. Dangdut is the music of my country.
Aku iki seheran. Kadang masih ada aja pelaku dangdut alias artis dangdut itu masih dianggap murah. Termasuk saya dulu. Mungkin sekarang ada beberapa. Ada yang anggap norak, kurang kelas, disepelekan, bahkan gak dianggap. Padahal tidak semuanya sih jelek. Bahkan kalau aku mau jujur, hiburan terbesar di Indonesia yang bisa menjangkau kelas atas dan bawah adalah dangdut. Tidak segmented dan mampu meraup rating juga di TV. Menghasilkan banyak duit. Kawinan dangdutan. Hotel mewah juga musiknya sekarang ada dangdutannya. Pop, rock, roncong, lagu Mandarin, lagu barat, semua bisa didangdutin. Bahkan kampanye kepala daerah pun sampai presiden dangdutan juga. Acara nyunat potong burung alias hitanan yo dangdutan. Hajatan dangdutan. Hampir 70% rakyat Indonesia nikmati sajian dangdut. Nilai dangdut itu cukup bagus akhir-akhir ini. Meskipun kadang sering dapat stigma negatif, tapi artisnya juga masih eksis. Tapi genre lain juga, kalau ngomongin pribadi orang, banyak juga yang tidak baik. Hanya pinter-pinter manajemennya aja untuk mengolah jadi image yang bagus dan menarik. Meskipun sebenarnya sosok artisnya punya nilai tidak bagus, alias artisnya image-nya jelek, tapi karena pinter-pinternya manajemen tuh, jadi tetap aja dikemasnya kelihatan bagus. Tidak semua pedangdut tidak berprestasi. Bahkan yang dari lahir nangis saja ada cengkoknya. Banyak juga karena berharap emak bapaknya anaknya nanti jadi generasi pedangdut. Karena apa? Cari duitnya gampang tanpa sekolah vokal seperti saya ini. Menurut aku dangdut itu sangat besar sih, karya seni yang harus dijaga. Kalau ada yang gak benar, diluruskan, bukan dibully atau dihakimi. Dangdut itu kaya, dari musiknya, semua bermain. Suara artisnya, wah, cengkok dangdutnya luar biasa. Tidak semua orang bisa bercengkok dangdut. Gerak olah tubuhnya meliuk-liuk. Semua punya nilai tersendiri. Urusan nilai estetikanya memang harus ada, tapi itu berproses. Jangan karena artis dangdut dicap minus, malah tidak diberi ruang. Harusnya diajarkan bagaimana menjadi penyanyi yang bagus, artis dangdut yang bagus. Saya dulu seperti apa, sekarang seperti apa. Itu yang berproses. Justru dulu aku bisa sejajar tampil sama yang lebih hebat. Diberi ruang, malah muncul keinginan termotivasi, terinspirasi dan berubah jadi lebih baik. Berkaca sama yang lebih baik. Tidak bisa pukul rata semua sama, karena kita ditakdirkan berbeda. Bayi kembar identik aja kalau ngentut juga gak bisa barengan kan? Berbeda itu bukan aneh, berbeda itu indah. Dangdut is the music of my country. Para penonton, bapak-bapak, ibu-ibu, semua yang ada di sini. Ada yang bilang dangdut tak goyang, bagai sayur tanpa garam, kurang enak, kurang sedap. Dari itu Indul goyang, agar semuanya senang. Bagi yang kurang berkenan,
melihat Inul bergoyang. Jangan marah, maafkanlah.
The next one will be the English version of the story. Inul is still wondering. Sometimes the person involved in dangdut, the artist itself, is still considered cheap, including herself before, and also several current artists as well. Tacky, not classy. Underestimated, not even appreciated. Actually, not all of them are bad. In all honesty, the biggest entertainment in Indonesia, which can break the barrier of classes, is dangdut. Unsegmented and able to achieve good ratings in TV. Producing a lot of money. Weddings will have dangdut. Luxury hotels will also have dangdut in their list of music. Pop rock, kroncong, Mandarin songs, Western songs, all can be made into dangdut music. Even the campaigns for local government up to the president will have dangdut. Circumcision ceremonies will also use dangdut. Festive celebrations will also have dangdut. Almost 70% of Indonesians enjoy the music of dangdut. Lately, dangdut has been valued better, although its image is still given a negative stigma, and yet the artists continue to exist. In other music genres, not all of the artists' personalities are that great either, relying on their management to cook up a good and attractive image. Although its artist actually may not have a good image, but thanks to his or her management's clever ability to package them, they still appear good. Not all dangdut artists are without abilities. Many of them are born with the talent, who maybe as babies were able to cry with dangdut's unique voice twist. Their parents are hopeful that they one day become dangdut singers because it's easy money, without the requirement of vocal lessons such as those taken by Inul. In Inul's opinion, dangdut is a huge art form that needs to be preserved. If there is something that is not right, then it needs to be corrected, not bullied or judged. Dangdut is rich. Its music, all instruments blending in, its artist's voice with that characteristic twist which not all people can do, its provocative dance movements, all have their own values. It's a process to develop its aesthetic value. One should not deny the platform for dangdut artists just because they are considered less than other artists. They should be taught how to become good singers, good dangdut artists. Where Inul started, where she is now, it is all due to process. Those times when Inul had the opportunity to perform on stage with those who were already more successful sparked the desire, motivation, inspiration within her to continue to learn and become better, taking notes from those better than herself. Not everyone can be compared equally. We are all destined to be different. Even identical twin babies will not do everything together, including farting. Different is not strange. Different is beautiful. Dangdut is the music of my country. Audience, gentlemen, ladies who are here, someone said, dangdut without dance moves is like a dish without salt. It's not delicious, it's not good. That's why Inul is dancing, so everyone is happy. For those who don't like seeing Inul dancing, don't get angry. Please forgive. This is a story from Inul Daratista, a famous dangdut singer and entrepreneur in Indonesia from Pasuruan, East Java, who is currently residing in Jakarta. She rose to fame after her televised concert in Jakarta in January 2003. She is well known for her signature dance moves, which she calls Goyang Inul, Goyang Gerudi, or Ngebor, which literally means drilling. These gyrating hip dance moves were also the source of controversy with other dangdut singers and some conservative organizations in Indonesia, as those were deemed immoral, inappropriate, and would tarnish the dangdut music. They tried to ban her concerts, but these actions and criticisms actually helped her become even more popular with the dangdut audience. Inul is also active through her social media, being quite outspoken about the injustice, inequality, and inhumanity issues in Indonesia. As this is one of our editions, as we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we can all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn that how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us. I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes. These are our stories. What is yours?